We'll Be Home for Christmas will be presented by three readers with a special appearance by Carmen Gomez. Producer-director Cecil Gomez tells a story through an audio-vision experience.
What I'm trying to do is make people aware of the war, and especially in this one, that that war had consequences that we still feel today. But obviously, some people feel that it's going to be very morbid, but I don't. I mix up some humor too, because in the war, the soldiers found that the only way life was so bad that they had to find things that were funny. So they had funny names for trenches, they made jokes, they had special songs and all sorts of things. I'll do the same here, because otherwise, you know, it would be unbearable. So we do have two of our prima donnas actually sing a song, you see. And we have another one about rain and mud. Those are the humorous side, and obviously the serious side. And I must make sure that I present most of the important things that happened that year. And one was very important, which was what happened in the Middle East, which affects us now, and what happened in Russia, which affected the Germans a lot later on, in fact.
The research has been extensive from a wide range of sources. The year, 1917.
Every year I've given it a bit of a bias, and this year the bias is on the role of women during the war, either in active service or the fact that they all started having jobs they never had during their lives, and we do explain that too.
The presentation is not just historical, but aims to have a wider appeal. At times, it's a personal view. At times, a personal story.
Ever so often, the casualties come up, and to make people aware of how many people died. And we also have, actually we have something special which I'd like to mention. There was a letter in the Chronicle from Mr. Ernest Redding about his great uncle. And I wrote to him in the Chronicle, and then he phoned me, and because I said I've added a bit at the last moment, talking about this man who actually died in the Battle of Arras, which we do in 1917. And I refer to him the fact that he died there, his body was never discovered. And then actually I'm doing in the first part, asking for a minute's silence for him. But every presentation, we always end up at the end where we ask the audience to stand and we hear the last post, and then in silence we see how many people died or were missing or were wounded, you know. So it's an overall picture, and we use poetry too.
Tickets are available from the Garrison Library from 10 to 4:30 and at Sacarello's coffee shop. The entrance price includes a drink.